And now your host, National Public Radio science correspondent, Ira Flatow.
Thank you. Welcome to Newton's Apple. This is the program that answers your questions about science, medicine, technology, the world around us. Now, why the program's unusual name? Of course, it comes from the old tale about Isaac Newton's discovery of gravity when an apple fell on his head. Unfortunately, that's not what really happened. Even in Newton's time, people knew about gravity, but the story is retold time and again because it shows that hidden among the simplest occurrences in nature, like the falling of an apple, lie fascinating and important ideas. And that's what we hope that Newton's Apple will mean to you. We want to stimulate you to ask questions about the world just like Isaac Newton did. Now, you can ask simple or complicated questions. We'll try to answer all of them. We'll mix in some of our own questions, too. And we may not discover gravity, but we will give you a lot to think about, and we should have a good time along the way. So let's get right on to our first question. It comes from?
Paul Nigerian.
Now, Paul, you wrote us a question a while ago. You wanted to know what?
Yeah, I wanted to know, according to all the national average surveys, they say that I'm 70 pounds overweight.
You don't look it.
Thanks. I don't think I look it either, and I sure don't feel it. Now, I was wondering if there was a way that you could tell exactly how much overweight you are.
Mm-hmm. Well, fortunately, there is a way to figure that out, and here to explain is Dr. Robert Surfas from the University of Minnesota. Okay, Dr. Surfas, let's answer that question, if you could. How do you know if you have too much fat or if you're overweight?
Well, there are several ways to do that, Ira, and the way that most people are familiar with is to take a look at a height-weight chart like this.
Well, I'm familiar with this one. You see it in magazines and doctor's offices.
That's right. Now, you're 5'8", and so your weight would fall somewhere along this line down here, but the big question is whether or not you have a small frame, a medium frame,
Good
or a
point.
Large frame, right?
Of course, I want to have a large frame, right?
Everybody wants to have a large frame because it allows them to have more fat, right, or more weight. Now, you can use a height-weight table like this, but it's very possible that you may be heavier than the highest value on this chart and still not be over fat.
Just like the guy in the audience who asked the question.
Right.
He certainly didn't look fat.
No, he doesn't look over fat at all. And this is very common with athletes who do a lot of weight training. They're very muscular, so they're very heavy, and they're off the charts here, but they have a reasonable amount of fat. So the real question is, how much fat do you have, not just what's a reasonable weight?
And the real answer is?
And the real answer can be determined one way by taking a look at the amount of fat that's underneath your skin. A lot of the fat is stored underneath the skin. If you pick up two layers of skin in front of your wrist, there's almost no fat there.
That's
just
very
two layers of skin.
Here.
But if you go any other place in your body, you'll find lots of fat
there. I'm afraid to look.
Right. And so if we look behind your arm or on your back or on your abdomen, we're going to take a skin fold, measure of fat just above your hip bone here, which is
you
a very commonly measured site.
It's what we call the love handles, right?
Right. So if we take
All America gets to see mine.
Take this measurement here, and indeed we can see that you've got about 14 millimeters of fat in that area there. Now, we took earlier six sites on you and used a chart to determine or estimate that your percent fat with this method, using the skin fold method, is about 17.5% or 17% body fat.
Give me the news. Is that?
That's not too bad because average for your age group would be around 15% or so. So 17 is just a little fatter than normal, than average.
A little more of me to love.
A little more of you to love, right.
Now, how accurate is this method?
Well, that's reasonably accurate, but there's even a better way of doing it, and you're going to love this method because if you go back here...
I'm waiting for this one.
Right. You get a chance to dive into this hot tub and swim around and
play with a sailboat. It's not every science show that gives you the opportunity to have fun in a hot tub, so...
Right. And this is another way of determining body fatness. And this way is... to determine what your body density is.
What do you mean by body density?
Well, your body density is actually your weight per unit volume. In other words, very simply put, you can say that fat floats, and your body is made up of fat and other lean tissues. No, I didn't have you in mind. But indeed, your fat will float, and your other tissues, like your bones and your muscles, will sink. So that the less you weigh underwater, the more fat you have, the less dense you are. So we're going to compare your out-of-the-water weight with your underwater weight and try to determine what your body fatness is by computing your density. So I
what
want
do you want
to
me to do here?
Sit in this chair. I want you to sit
in this
chair.
This is easier looking than it... All right, I think I'm balanced in the chair.
Okay.
About 2 feet underwater.
All right, now what I want you to do now is we have to get all of the air that's possible to get out of your lungs. So I want you to blow all the air out of your lungs and then lean slowly over and get yourself completely underwater.
All right, okay? Here we go. Okay, there I gotta go underwater.
Blow all the air out of your lungs, all out of your lungs. Right, and good, 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 good. Okay, come on up. Come on up. That's good. Good.
Not as easy as it looks, folks.
No, it takes a little learning. Actually, yes. We do this a couple of times in the laboratory.
Now, what did you find out by that?
Well, it's interesting to note that out of the water, you weigh about 157 pounds. Mm. When you're in the water, you weigh about 9.5 pounds, wow. And we have to subtract the 2 pounds or so that is represented by the weight of this chair.
There's a lot of stuff floating in there.
Now we can compute your density and your percent body fat. So if we make that computation, and we do it and correct for the air that's in your lungs, which gives a floating effect, mm-hmm. we find out that your body fat computed by this underwater weighing method is actually about 16% and not the 17 or 17.5% by that method.
I certainly like this method better than that method.
I'm sure you would. And so that the height weight charts are very general. Body composition by using the caliper is a little better method. And this is even a little better.
Now, who would use? Now, you're not going to get everybody into a contraption like this. This is not for everybody,
no,
right? The chart might be good for most people.
The chart is good generally, and skin folds, many doctors do it in their office these days.
And there is a definite kind of person that should worry about how much body fat he has versus how much he weighs.
Yeah, you should have a reasonable amount of fat. In other words, people who are overweight and where that overweight is really represented by a large amount of fat, those people are more prone to have things like diabetes and hypertension. So you should be concerned about your fatness.
And do men and women have the same kind of fat problem?
No, women have a little bit more fat than men do. So whereas the upper end of the scale for reasonable fat for men would be maybe 20%, women may be up around 27 or 28%. So they can carry a little bit more fat and still be average or reasonable.
Now there's always a last question. It's something that people always wonder about. When do you start becoming fat? Is there a point in life when that's established?
Well, there's more and more research being gathered to suggest that most of the fat cells that you develop are developed while you're growing. So it's very important to take care of this fatness or obesity question when you're young, because if you do it when you're young, you're not as likely to be overweight and obese when you're older.
I was a pretty skinny kid, so there's still a chance for me to lose some of this weight, right?
That's right.
Okay, well, thank you very, very much, Dr. Sir Fast, for coming. And we'll be back with the dry part of the show in just a moment.